Okay, so today's topic is how to raise all the funds you need for your city efforts. Now, some of you, I know you already have all the money you need, right? If you have all the money you need, raise your hand. Anybody? No, I don't see any hands raised. Okay, so this is applicable. We all need to raise more funds so we can make a bigger difference, right? In the communities we live here. So what I want to do is start off in a breakout. And so you're going to be with a couple people that maybe you know, you don't know. If so, just introduce yourself. Maybe to everybody, just introduce yourself a little bit, where you're from, and just brief intros. But I want us to answer these questions, and it's real simple. What's working for you, and what's not working for you? And so, in two components, as it comes to the volunteer day, your volunteer day, what's working for you in raising funds? What's not working for you? And then year-round efforts. If you have year-round efforts, what's working for you, what's not working for you? And let's just see if we can learn a little bit from each other and get ideas from each other. Then we'll bring it back in. Let's take up five, maybe even up to, well, let's go over 5 minutes here. Let's spend some time. I think there's a lot of good stuff that we're gonna hear from each other. So I'm gonna attempt to do this breakout thing. I miss Dave. There it is. Breakout rooms. Okay, so we're gonna do, let's do five rooms. Let's see how this thing goes. All right, here it goes. All right, there it goes. Sweet. All right, man, that could we could spend the whole time and just hanging with each other. But what I want to do is this. I'm going to share a little bit, and then I'm going to open it up for questions, and I'm going to have some of you guys share with everyone some maybe some ideas that you have in raising funds for the volunteer day as well as for year round, as we learn from each other. So hey, my story is basically this. I started Love Modesto started out of a church, and so the church was funding everything. It was pretty nice, actually. I didn't have to worry about anything. And when we started, that was one thing that we debated was like, do we just stay under this model? The church pays. I don't go to church meetings, but we just get all the funding, you know, that we thought that we needed. The best decision we made was against them, because whoever funds is most invested into it. Does that make sense? Like whoever the funding comes for. So if you got like multiple funders, people that are owning this thing and that will want to volunteer, that want to get involved. And so whoever writes the check, that's what I learned early on, is going to have the most interest in everything. So the more funders, the better. Even at little bits, you know, because even the little bits says they have a stake in what's going on. So when we started, it was like, holy cow, how do we do this? We tried this texting campaign. We said, hey, if everyone gave $10, you know, two cups of coffee, you know, $10. If we had 5,000 people giving $10, man, that's some good money coming in. Yeah, it didn't work. People didn't, the texting, and I could tell you there's so many other ideas that didn't work. But here's something that did work. So I had someone who said, listen, I feel sorry. Let me help you. You're getting this thing off the ground. Let me help you. And so she cold called 400 businesses and churches and organizations. I mean, she just, I mean, we, 'cause we didn't have, you know, really a lot of relationships at all. So just total cold call. And we did use that model of she came, she had this idea because a lot of people do these gold, silver, bronze. You should have a gold, silver, bronze. You know, we got all these projects we have. Maybe the larger projects, 15 above volunteers, will be gold. Maybe the silver projects will be between 25 and 50 volunteers, and the bronze projects would be, you know, less than 25 volunteers. And putting the price point at $250 for bronze, 500 for silver, and 1,000 for gold. That's what we went with. And so she ended up getting 60 people to say yes for the first year we did this. 60 people said yes. And we raised $26,500 for our very first year. And I made some calls too, by the way. It wasn't just her, but she was the one that was really amazingly driving this thing. 10 years later, here we are. We've had a total of 200 and over 230 businesses, churches, and organizations who have said yes. And last year we had over 110 said yes, and we raised over $160,000. Our price points changed. So let me share with you, if I can, my screen, our model. Okay, so here you see, here's our website, by the way. Looks similar to your guys's website, but hey, by the way, this is a great time. A lot of there's a lot of spring cities going on, and you see the list in your chat. Visit other cities' websites, learn from other cities and how they're doing things, how they're wording things and organizing things. This is a great time to look at everybody's website right now. And so, you know, there's our website. Here's sponsors that are coming together here. But if you click on the sponsor button, you'll see kind of how we have this organized here. Let me see if I can make this a little bit bigger here. So now we've got event, platinum, gold, silver, bronze, and our price points have changed. Now, we live in Modesto. We're not Orange County. We don't have near the money that Orange County has. So our price points might be a little bit less, but it works here. I think every city's got to figure out what your price points are, what your you know, city can do. But certainly, if you're one of the bigger sponsors, you're going to get more. Here's all the things that we're going to give you. You know, a vendor booth, you're going to have your logo on posters, on project signs, the big banner, you know, website. We're going to do videos. We're just going to hit the ball out of for you. And you know, as it goes down, you get a little bit less, you know, each time. That's just how it goes, right? And so this, I don't know, man, somehow this model just works. It's not just for our city. I know other cities it's working as well. So that's kind of a picture of how we raise dollars for our city here. Now let me show you this if I can. How do we raise money year round? So the big ask, and if you see this, but it's our annual sponsorship. And so for $20,000, You know, you get your on everything, all of our five big events we do throughout the year. I'll send this out in an email. But all of our big events, you get primo title sponsorship on the major things we do throughout the year. This has been a huge win, raising, you know, 100 grand on top of, you know, everything else we do to support our efforts. Let me see what else here. Yeah, so let's talk about retaining sponsors. It's one thing to get someone on board. How do you retain them year after year, right? That's huge. And I think, you know, first of all, you got to share your data of what happened during that day or your events throughout the year. You got to do that well and compelling. You got to let people know. I can even share this on an email. You know, here's how many retirement homes we help. Here's how many parks we clean. Here's how many. I mean, there's something about that data. You know, that is, and how many dollars that equated to, volunteer dollars that equated to. Also sharing stories, man. It's not just about numbers, it's about stories. It's about people seeing lives that are being impacted and changed. And man, last year we helped this one guy, AC heating company. They installed a whole new unit in this the guy's house, right? And he's on camera, and he did it on the local television station, got him too. Just emotionally saying, this has changed his life. Like he's been never able to do this. And he was just so grateful for Love Modesto. And it was just amazing. Like just stories are of impact are super, super important. You know, it's all about relationships and trust. That's what it comes down to. I think we have a chapter in our book that talks about this. It's in your community, it's relationships and trust that's going to retain sponsorship. So throughout the year, patronizing these businesses, saying hi to them. You know, when something you hear something good going on, you celebrate. When something's hard going on, you reach out. I mean, it's just this ongoing relationship, you know, with these supporters, you know, in your community. Another thing we've done is we have this certificate. I don't know if you see this. It's blurred. Whatever. I'll send this out as well. But a certificate of appreciation that businesses can put up, you know. And so we go to every one of these businesses every year to make sure they have one of these. We used to have the name of the business, but now we got so many sponsors, so it's such a logistical nightmare. So we just have this kind of general kind of certificate. We've got these poster cards they can put up, you know, in their business as well. Proud, you know, we love Modesto, proud sponsor. We got decals they can put on their door, and it's so cool. All around our town, you see these things with all these businesses that are part. So that's really, really, really huge. Another thing I want to share is having an impact report. If your organization or if your city doesn't have an impact report, and it could be real small about what you did that last year or something, you know, if you do more things throughout the year, but having something like this, if you go to Love Waterford's website and or their social media, they do a great job. They just released their impact report. And so I'm going to send this out as well that you can kind of see an idea of people who financially give, they want to know their dollars are being maximized and they deserve that. And so we have an obligation to share, you know, the data, the stories, the photos, the videos, and all that, you know, really well in that way. So, hey, let me stop there for a second. Any questions that you have? And then I want to open it up for y'all to share some of the things you're doing in your community. But any questions about what I just shared that you have that I could be a help to you? Wonderful. Said it all. I didn't know if I was going to say everything. So let's do this. I want a couple of your cities to share. What are some of your successful ideas? And let's start with the volunteer day that has worked for you really well when it comes to raising funds for that volunteer day, supporting that volunteer day, and maybe even beyond that volunteer day. But let's just start there for a little bit. Can a couple of our cities here share what are some ideas that have really worked well for you? That we can learn from you. Don't make me call on you. I've been known to do this.
I'll just start, Jeff. Last year we started after our citywide volunteer day doing kind of a local nonprofit fair and a picnic, community picnic. And so from like 12 to 2 after our citywide volunteer day, and we had about 15 local nonprofits, and then we had like the Kiwanis come out, So we got a corporate sponsor for the whole event, and Love Lodi has never really found, it's always been funded through a church. And so we started reaching out more to the business community and the nonprofit community, and even going back to the church community, and just like you said, relationship and trust, but just kind of showcasing and saying, we want to be a champion of volunteerism in our whole city, not just on our citywide volunteer day. Obviously that's the catalyst for this, but just saying, hey, we want to champion volunteerism everywhere. And so we want to showcase local nonprofits. And I think between that, we found more people willing to, because they didn't really know what Love Lodi was. They just said, yeah, I love Lodi. Mm-hmm. But it was like, no, we're a citywide volunteer day, and just really trying to rebrand and recast the vision of what it is. And that's been really impactful. And we're getting more and more traction. And so like in the fall, we call it a food truck frenzy. And we have a local winery, and we brought out a bunch of people, raffle baskets, and we raise money just for the schools in the fall. So we're like, we're going to love Lodi schools in the fall, and then we're going to do the Citywide Volunteer Day in the spring. And so over the last 2 years, we've seen growing traction and working specifically with Title I schools that don't have parent clubs or PTAs, because we learned in our community how that impacts the school. And so we've kind of becoming de facto PTAs and helping them get their feet off the ground. And so like we just got in our district, there's this thing called house shirts. And so we helped one local school just purchase all of their house shirts. And then we're in the process of doing that for a middle school. And so we're going and getting sponsors for that. So it's just, I think it's like you said, the data and showing them what you're doing. Cause for a lot of people they're like, what do you do? And so we're trying to get that messaging out. So
thank you, Tim. Anyone else? Come on. What are some ideas that are working in your city and raising funds for the volunteer day as well as maybe year round?
I'll go. Candace Wyrock. I'm from Love Patterson. And something that works really well for us, we don't have anyone in full-time ministry. I'm probably the closest because I homeschool my kids. So I'm technically the only one without a real full-time job. But because of that, we all have different ties to different organizations, different nonprofits, different businesses in town. So we sit down at the start of our fundraising year and popcorn style around the table and get people to tell us, you know, okay, oh, I'll take, you know, I take all the Chamber of Commerce businesses because I have personal relationships with them, because I'm also on the board for the Chamber of Commerce. So I take those. And then my realtor friend, she takes all the realtors in town. Like, so we kind of popcorn style on who's going to take the business based on if we have personal relationships with them. And that really kind of only works because we are a small town. But the other thing I was saying in the breakout room right before the session ended is that we also have good relationships with our city council. So because of that, our city is the largest donor of our event. So they give us our biggest donation check, and showing the city council members the projects we can do in their districts, showing them how we're able to take their donation check and make it stretch a lot farther because we bring in volunteers where they would have to pay employees. It's just really, that's our bread and butter. Once we get that check, we know, okay, the rest of the checks will start coming in. So making sure you have a good relationship with those people and that they understand the value of what you're doing and what you're able to accomplish, and that they realize that we can accomplish more than they can for that same dollar amount.
How many of you, your city government is supporting your efforts? Raise your hand. That's good. You know, I learned, and I was on a call like this a couple of years, literally probably 3 years ago, I think it was, that I was hearing about city governments that were supporting their efforts, and our city was not doing that. So I'm like, dang it, I'm gonna learn from you guys. So I went to my city, and yeah, they're one of our event sponsors now, which is, yeah, pretty significant. Someone else. What are some ideas, successful ideas that you could share with us?
Well, I can share a little bit. So our organization, we don't specifically fundraise for our serve days. So it's kind of a broader ask. So, and we get funding from a variety of different ways. We do some grants from our city. We have individual donors, so individuals, churches, businesses donate, and then sponsorship. So similar, so we do have a big backpack bash. So it's not a serve day, but it's a backpack bash. Similar, Jeff, to what you were saying about the sponsorship levels, that has been huge too. So based on your level, like you were saying, you get your logo gets to be larger or something like that, has been really helpful. Another thing we do with our serve days is have people sponsor specific projects. So things that people really care about. One thing we do is a nursery design. So an interior designer works with a mom who wasn't expecting to take her baby home to remake, like, in one day, that space. So that space that the baby gets to come home to, a safe space that's, you know, really cool. And so people sponsor those specifically because there are some people who care about specific things. And so sponsorships for that has been really great as well. And then we've also done some themed fundraisers, like, again, for our organization wide. And that has been really fun. We've been very surprised the past 2 years that people have totally embraced, like, we did a Roaring Twenties themed fundraiser. And people really embraced it. We had no idea that people would come on a Thursday night dressed in, like, flapper dresses. Like, it was wild. So that's been fun too, like a themed party as well.
Oh, that's great. And thank you, Gina. Others, what are you doing? How are you raising funds in your city? Nobody. All the ideas are out there.
I'll go quick. I was saying this in our chat too. This is Gail from Laguna Beach. We've only done it 2 years, so we're still really building up our initiative, but we were having trouble getting the other churches. We have a few churches, it's not a lot, but getting them on board. And so we had them, one of them that it enticed them to do it was to sponsor an actual project. And we did a new garden at the elementary school. And so they loved having kind of being able to say that we replanted the garden at Top of the World Elementary School. And so then they gave money towards all the supplies that went to that. And we featured, you know, that and had them obviously on the t-shirt. And so they wanted kind of to have that notoriety a little bit. But it was good. And then it motivated their congregants to go out and volunteer as well, just so they didn't have to look for a project, but hey, let's all volunteer on this one project. So that has helped. That helped get another church involved and kind of have the buy-in. But I love the whole city thing. So this year we're really going to try to work on getting our city a little bit more involved. We have a gal from the Parks and Recs that helps, but the city council, I think, just figures she's doing it and they don't really need to be involved. So I like that idea a lot of doing that. So thanks for that. And for the certificate of appreciation, I think that'll go a long way in our small town with the businesses. That's a huge takeaway. So thank you.
You're welcome.
If you can get your city council members or mayor to actually volunteer, the community loves that.
We did last year had our, I think she was Mayor Pro Temp. She came out, which was huge, and she loved it. So that was good. But so we did at least get one last year. So that was good. So we're going to keep doing that exactly and push to have them get on a project. It's a great idea.
It's good.
And then, like, one thing I just wanted to add, like, off what she's saying too, was for us changing the, us becoming co-chairs, and it was always just funded by one church, Love Lodi, and we had no funds in the bank at the end of our, you know, volunteer day. Practically speaking, you know, we did the rotations of finding out, like, the Kiwanis, all the Rotaries, City Council, Lodi Improvement. Like, we just did, like, got in front of all of these businesses and people and bugged them. And recasting the vision of Love Lodi, I was shocked how many of them had no idea what Love Lodi was.
Wow.
And they're sitting in these, you know, positions. And that was, like, one, like, practical way of getting more involvement from our city officials, from business owners. And then when we did, like, a mixer, like, one of our first mixers was completely free. And the whole purpose of that was to get the city council, all these to-do people into one location. We had about 89 of them show up, and we just casted the vision of Live Lodi and what we're trying to do all year long. That was impactful. That has helped us now more and more, where they're going, oh, Live Lodi is not just one day for us. It's all year long.
That's good. Very, very good.
I was going to add real quickly. Also, you had mentioned the certificate of appreciation. We also added a digital piece to that where we sent people like a little badge that they could put on their email signature or social media or something like that. So 2023 sponsor something, something. So a digital certificate of appreciation or a digital badge was kind of fun for those businesses too.
Hey, can y'all do that? I would love to see that. Some of these other ideas, can y'all, I say y'all, like I went to school in Virginia and it came out. can you send me, I'm in California. Can you send, you like that, Chris? Where's Chris at here? Yeah, I think he'd appreciate my Southern language. Before 9 o'clock, can you send me your ideas? And I want to put that, I'm going to couch them all in an email. I'm going to try to put them all in an email so we can kind of see the different ideas, some of the ones that I shared, but some of the ones that you shared as well. If you have any, like a flyer of your fundraising event, your 20s party event, of you know, something that's succinct that we can kind of grab a hold of, kind of what it's all about and how you're raising funds, please send that before 9 a.m. And then I'm going to put that, I'm going to try to put them all in an email so we all can see and learn from each other. There is one theme that I am hearing again and again and again, really post, you know, COVID here, if we are post or not, whatever that means, is before COVID, churches were way more major funding than they are now. And I think that's just the reality, is their churches, by and large, they're not giving as much or they're not giving at all anymore. And it doesn't mean I think they're not supportive of what we're doing. They just, you know, everybody's cutting back. Church attendance is down 50%. Giving is down. I mean, that's just how it goes. So if you're just relying on churches to support your efforts, you're probably not going to last very long. But if you rely, open this up, and that's what I'm hearing, is to the whole community, the Big C church or just the Big C community, then I think you're going to get all the funding, you know, that you need. I still love going to churches first. I still believe in churches, and it's a volunteer force in the community. But yeah, we have to enlarge our vision. And I think when we do that, we're going to enlarge the number of volunteers we have too. If you just rely on church volunteers, you're going to only have so many people. But if you open up to the whole community, you're going to have a whole lot more people. So that's a theme. And maybe it's not, it's like exact science in your city, but man, I'm hearing it again and again and again. This is the trend of where this thing is going here. So, all right, let's do this. We're going to end here early. Yay. But I want to talk about next month. Here's the question we're gonna ask here. How do you increase the number of your volunteers by 30% in your volunteer day, as well as your year-round efforts? And I've got some ideas to share, and I've got some others that we'll be sharing as well on if you want to, which we all do, we want to have bigger impact, more volunteers, all that. I'm telling you, I think there's some proven principles and ideas that we're going to be talking about next month that will up your efforts in a tremendous way here. So if you have any questions about our website, and a lot of us are really, you know, obviously we're diving into our website, getting our volunteer days coming here in the spring, or if you're planning even getting your website ready for the rest of the year, stay on the call and we'll try to answer some of those questions that you have. Is Jamie on the call? Rick, can you text Jamie and see if she can jump on the call? Because she's going to be the one manually answering those questions. I'll do the best I can do, but she is going to answer those questions. By the way, I got baby pictures from Danielle. She had her baby here a few weeks ago now, but healthy baby, healthy family, super. Yeah, it's just super exciting. Happy for them. But Danielle will be back in later May. She takes her maternity leave off for that. So I think that is it. Blessings to y'all. Have a great day today. And Katie, we'll be talking afterwards as well. Have a great day, everybody. Okay, how do I?